Hello, good afternoon everybody. I'm Dr. Tan Wee Yong. I'm the consultant neurologist at Thompson Hospital Kota Damansara. How to recognize symptoms of stroke? So, stroke symptoms come very abruptly. So, it happens in an instant. So, the most common symptoms are face become droopy, A for arms, arm become weak, and also S is speech becomes slurred, and T is time. So when you have all these symptoms, you should go to your nearest hospital as soon as possible to find out whether this is a stroke or not. I am now in my early 40s and are bracing for old age. What can I do as a semi-old person to avoid stroke? So to prevent this, I would say the most important is to prevent all these three important chronic diseases like hypertension, diabetes, and also hypercholesterol. How to prevent these three diseases? Mostly from food intake, you must control your food intake to avoid overly salty food, overly sweet food, or overly oily food. And of course, you have to pair with exercise and do a regular every year checkup. Does alcoholism lead to stroke? Unfortunately, yes. So alcoholism itself will trigger your heart to beat more. So alcoholism has been shown to cause more atrial fibrillation. Atrial fibrillation is a type of disorder when your heart beats irregularly. When your heart beats irregularly, it produces a blood clot which will travel from the heart to the brain, and this will cause a stroke. What stroke warning should I look for while I am still young? I would say the warning sign is still the same, FASD. But sometimes young people who neglect the sign, they feel that they are in a very low risk category of getting a stroke. However, if you have this FASD symptom, you should still think of a stroke even though you are still young. I have seen patients as young as in the early 30s who have stroke, and they do not think they actually have a stroke, and waited 1 or 2 days and the symptom become worse, and this become a very difficult condition to treat if they miss the golden hours. Is stroke hereditary? What can I do to lower my risk of getting it? I would say some of it yes, some of it no. So which type of stroke is hereditary? If you have inherited the gene of getting more diabetes, if you have a gene of being the possibility of having become easily obese, then you are. But however, most of it is due to our unhealthy lifestyles. Is the paralysis caused by stroke permanent? This is, I think, a debatable condition. Paralysis caused by stroke sometimes can recover, and it all depends on a few factors. First is, when do you come for follow-up? Is it as during the golden hour? Number two, are you getting the correct medication? Are you addressing the predisposing factors? Are you motivated enough to go for rehabilitation? And are you having the real good support from the doctors, from the nurses, from the family, from the rehab team? And also not to forget from your working force. Because all this come together to help in the rehab. And with all this, I think most of the stroke patients can recover. Because there is a concept we call neuroplasticity, that means that your brain can recover somehow after some treatment within the first golden 6 months period. What goes on in the mind of a person who has a stroke? Are there ways for them to communicate? Most of the family always ask me, are they conscious? Are they able to understand them? I think most of the patients, they have ability to communicate. Unless there is a severe stroke at the place that governs our communication area, that is on the left side of the brain, a specific area. So if a patient has a stroke, I think he can at least communicate with a sign language or sometimes by writing. For the patient to communicate actually is very important. It helps to alleviate their frustration when they cannot move. And also it avoids the depression. So my papa got a stroke the other day. He eat a lot of nonsense. So what I'm asking is there anything I should definitely take off his plate to lower his stroke incidence? Well, this is a very, very common because we are blessed with a lot of nice food in Malaysia. So I will usually ask my patient to try to eat healthily and to eat when you are 70% full. and try to avoid at least greasy, sweet stuff for at least for the first to 3 months, and try to moderate your food intake. What I usually advise my patient is, if you want to get better, you have to participate in your own care. We as doctors and also healthcare professional can maybe help you to 50 to 60%, but the rest depends on you. How does a person die from stroke? So stroke is a very debilitating disease. Some people do die instantaneously. That means they die within 24 hours to 48 hours from the stroke, especially a massive stroke. That means their stroke comes from a bleeding in the brain, the pressure builds up, and then they stop breathing. The other type is they usually die from the complication of stroke, like they when they lie down without appropriate care, then get infected sores, infected lungs, and they do slowly die off because of malnutrition at some point. However, most of the stroke can be prevented. So that's why I really strongly advise for prevention of stroke. Why only old people get a stroke? I think this is a myth. I do not think that only old people get a stroke. They do have stroke if they are older, because part of the risk factor when you get older, you get more sick. But in recent years, I do see more people getting, younger people getting stroke, because I do think Malaysia is getting more and more obese, and this is the reason they're getting more stroke and the lack of exercise and more comorbid issue. How do you take care of someone who has stroke? Should I hire a home nurse? I think stroke patient has variable outcome. Some of them do recover very well, almost 90%. Some of them do require some form of home care nursing. I think that to hire a home care nurse is maybe too early when you have a stroke. Sometimes maybe after a few weeks of intensive treatment, some patients do get back to their own feet. Maybe not a home nurse, maybe some modification at your home to install some rail, to be vigilant, to teach the patient how to call for emergency help. What if I delay for treatment if I notice symptoms of stroke? Well, this is, I think, one of the most important questions. Every second when you delay treatment, neurons die. Neurons is the cell in your brain. So to give an equivalent, 1 minute, you will have around 100,000 cells die if you delay the treatment. Lastly, the question, okay, if I don't have a phone with me when someone had a stroke, how? Is there anything I can do to help when someone else find help? First, let the patient lie down in an open space. Try not to crowd the patient, and try to disperse any crowd, and let the patient breathe to have a breathe and air, and dispatch somebody to call for help. As a major tertiary hospital, we are well equipped to handle any stroke emergency, be it stroke, hemorrhagic, or as any ischemic stroke. We have a dedicated team of neurologists, neurosurgeons, interventional radiologists, fully equipped ICU to handle any stroke emergency. If you have any stroke emergency, please feel free to contact our emergency services, and we'll be there at 24 hours, 7 days a week. Thank you.